Hi guys, welcome to another video. TOPN, a formula that is very useful and also used a lot. However, if you're using TOPN within a measure, it hides some complexity. In this video, I'm going to make sure you understand how to use TOPN, and I'm going to enhance your understanding of filter context. So stay tuned. So here I am in Power BI, and I have this extremely basic data model, just a few clients in a client table, and then there's a few sales transactions in a sales table, and obviously there's a relationship between the two tables. Okay, the first thing that I want to do is create the TOPN formula for a table, and I want to rank the clients based upon their sales. I do need to add that measure to my data model, determining the sum of the sales of my clients. So let's go ahead and add a new measure. And then let's increase the size of the font a bit. Okay, so sum of the sales would equal the sum of the sales. Okay. Sales table, sales column. Okay, so now that that has been created, let's go ahead and add that table to the model. So I add a new table, being the top one client. So this is going to be a table that is only going to have one record. So TOPN, so I specify the amount of top ranking clients I want to have in this table. We're going to keep things simple for now. So we're just going to have one. The table will be my clients table. And then I'm going to order them by the measure I just created, the sum of their sales. So this is going to end up with the client that bought the most. Now let's add this to a measure. So here goes. Let's add that new measure to our sales table. So I'm going to just go ahead and click new measure. And we need to use calculate. If you're not sure on calculate, so we do the top one clients. If you're not sure on calculate, make sure you watch my video on filter context, okay? So here we go, calculate. And we're going to use that same measure I've already created. And now here in the calculate statement, we're going to filter on that top one client. Okay, that one client based upon their sales. Okay, so if we add this to a cart, then I would expect that we only get to see the sales of the top one client. If we add that to a matrix, you would expect the same thing. So here we go. Let's add the clients to this matrix, add the sum of the sales, and add them the top one client. Let's make this a little bigger. There it goes. So there's something off. So the sum of the sales totals to 49. Top one clients, you would expect just Apple, and at the total level that works. We only get to see Apple, but at the individual client level, we get to see the sales of the individual clients, where you were only expecting to see any values for Apple. So what is going on here? We need to start off at the measure. This is the entire measure, and a measure gets evaluated within filter context. DAX is going to start off at that filter as a part of the calculate statement. So here it is, just the top end part. This is going to be evaluated within filter context. Again, if you're not sure on filter context, make sure you watch my video on filter context. So the first thing that happens is that the filter context gets filled. Okay, so in this example, Amazon is going to get added into that filter context. Next, the filters are going to get applied. So within the clients table, a filter on Amazon is applied. Then, on account of the relationship, that filter on client D, which is Amazon, is going to get propagated to the sales table. And then next, the sales table is also going to get filtered down to just that one client. Next, the math gets done. So after the filters have been applied, there's only one client left. So if we're going to look at the best client right now in terms of their sales, well, if there's only one client left, then that one client is going to be the best client. So this is going to be the result of the top end of that filter statement. So again, let's have a look at the entire measure. And then now we know that filter statement, the top end formula, is going to evaluate to client equal Amazon. Okay, so let's have a look at what's going to happen now. If we do the evaluation of this formula, first, Amazon is added into the initial filter context. Calculate is going to replace the initial filter context. In this example, by Amazon. Amazon gets replaced by Amazon. So that doesn't help. What is the issue here is that top end formula here respects the filter on Amazon. That is the issue. So how do we resolve that? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to specify that we want to have that top end based upon all clients. So not just the client coming out of the row header being entered into the filter context. We don't only want to have that client, we want to have this evaluation based upon all clients. So this is when we need to use the formula all. And now the result is going to be Apple. Okay, the result is going to be Apple. So now we're going to replace the initial filter context by what the calculate statement states. Then Amazon is going to get replaced by Apple. Okay, now that's not going to happen just for Amazon. This is going to happen for all of the rows here in this visual, right? This is a matrix visual, and for all of them, the initial filter, the context, is going to get replaced by whatever the calculation statement states. So this scenario, you might not want that. You probably don't want that. What you want here is to add an additional formula, which is keep filters. And what keep filters is going to do, keep filters is going to make sure that both the initial filter context as well as what has been added by the calculation statement get respected at the same time. Okay, so here, the initial filter context gets populated, and then the calculate statement is going to get added to the filter context. So now, what this is going to do for the first record, okay, it's going to say, well, I only want to have clients that are both Amazon and Apple at the same time. Okay, and so no clients are Apple and Amazon at the same time. So this is the result that we were going for. So here we are back in Power BI, and let me just make those two additions to this formula here. So first of all, we want to specify that we want to have the top end evaluation based upon all clients, not just the one coming out of the row header. So we need to specify that. And then second, we want to make sure that the initial filter context is respected along with whatever we've stated in the calculate statement. So that requires us to add a keep filters. Okay, so let me enter this, confirming the formula. Now we can see that indeed all we have left is the expected value for just Apple. And that's all there is to it.